Hello, and welcome to this history tutorial on poverty in Elizabethan England. This is for Edexcel GCSE History Elizabethan England. Today, we will cover how attitudes towards the poor changed during this period. The first thing you need to know about poverty in Elizabethan England is that people categorised those who were poor differently, and there were two types: the deserving poor and the undeserving or idle poor. Let's take a look at what each of these terms mean. The deserving poor. This term was used to describe those who were unable to work because of age or illness, so they were unable to support themselves. This included anyone who had a genuine disability that prevented them from working. It also included widows who were left with lots of children to care for, or orphans. The undeserving or idle poor. This was the term used to describe those who weren't fit to work but didn't. They often roamed the countryside looking for work. They were treated harshly and faced punishments such as whipping and prison. We know that poverty in Elizabethan England was growing. If you have not watched the tutorial on why was poverty increasing in Elizabethan England, you may wish to go and familiarise yourself with this now. The problem of poverty was becoming more visible, particularly in towns, as those who had lost their jobs in the countryside were coming to the towns to look for work. Due to the increased visibility of poverty, it was beginning to be recognised as a real problem that the government would need to deal with. Elizabeth and her government feared the increase in poverty as they believed that it may lead to social unrest and rebellion, so they realised they would need to try and do something to help the poor. The government therefore introduced new laws to try and tackle the problem of poverty in England. The first law that the government introduced was the Vagabonds Act of 1572, which aimed to stop vagrancy. As we know, vagrancy refers to people who were homeless and jobless, and these people were often roaming different areas to try and find work. The Vagabonds Act stated that vagrants were to be whipped and a hole drilled through each ear if caught. Vagrants were also to be imprisoned if they were arrested for a second time, and given the death penalty if it was their third offence. So rather than offer support to those in poverty, the Vagabonds Act was simply trying to stop vagrancy through punishment. The second law the government introduced was the Poor Relief Act of 1576. This act stated that justices of the peace were to provide the idle poor with wool and raw materials to enable them to work by making things to sell. Those who refused to work were sent to a special prison which was known as the House of Correction. So this act was somewhat of an improvement on the previous poor laws, as it actually offered some support to those who were in poverty by giving them a means to work. Despite the introduction of these new laws to tackle the issue of poverty, it remained a problem throughout Elizabeth's reign due to the fact that trade was disrupted massively by conflict with Spain and the revolt in the Netherlands. More and more vagabonds began to appear in towns and cities looking for work, so providing the poor with a means to make things to sell under the Poor Relief Act of 1576 helped the unemployed keep some independence and dignity, and often enabled them to stay in their own hometown or village. It is important, however, to recognise that some areas of the country were doing much better at dealing with the issue of poverty and poor relief. Ipswich, for example, established a school for poor children and a hospital for those who were poor because they were sick. In summary, the poor in Elizabethan England were classified in two different ways: the deserving poor, who were unable to work for a legitimate reason, and the undeserving or idle poor, who were fit to work but chose not to. In the Elizabethan era, poverty was a growing problem which the government recognised and tried to tackle through the introduction of a series of poor laws. We had the 1572 Vagabonds Act, which aimed to deter people from vagrancy through the use of harsh punishment, and the 1576 Act for the Relief of the Poor, which gave the idle poor resources so that they could produce the goods to sell. Those that refused to engage in this were sent to a special prison known as the House of Correction. Despite the laws that Elizabeth and her government introduced to solve the issue of poverty, it still remained a problem in this period due to the disruption to trade caused by conflict with Spain and the revolt in the Netherlands, which led to greater unemployment in England. To get further help, visit history.outwood.com, see your teacher in school, or check out quiz.outwood.com for those sweet revision quizzes. You can also follow the Outwood Humanities team on Twitter at OGATHumanities. Until next time, that was a little bit of history.